Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Our goal for this video is to understand the answer to the question, what is a transition state? So on this slide, we have a very familiar reaction, the reaction of HCl, a strong acid, with water to form hydronium, H3O+, and chloride. And I've drawn a sketch of the reaction coordinate for this particular reaction. This, you can see there's one peak on this reaction coordinate. Therefore, this is a one-step process. So at the dip on the left, we have our starting materials. Those would be HCl and water. Over here are our products, hydronium plus chloride. But what is going on in our transition state? The transition state is a peak in energy, not a dip in energy. And anything that's not a dip in energy is technically a hypothetical state because it doesn't have a measurable lifetime. You can't directly observe it. But if we went from our starting materials to our products, we know we must have at some point gone through the transition state. So what is this transition state? We can actually estimate what it might look like with chemical structures. So the mechanism of this reaction involves water, a lone pair on water, attacking the hydrogen on chlorine, and that is going to form a new OH bond as we break the old HCl bond. And the outcome of that reaction is drawn on the right. So we have a new OH bond, and now we have chlorine without a bond, it's chloride. So the transition state is some intermediate process. It's the transition between the two states. Which two states? The starting material and the product. It's our transition state. So how do we draw this? We have to actually try to draw partial bonds because we're going between having no bond between oxygen and hydrogen and having a new bond. So we'll have to draw something like a 1/2 bond. So we're going to use this lone pair to make a partial bond to hydrogen, and that dotted line is meant to be a partial bond. And of course, we're going to have a partial bond to chlorine because that bond is breaking. So to complete this transition state, we also need to talk about charges. All the atoms on the left are neutral. The oxygen and chlorine on the right have charges. So in the transition state, they're going to have partial charges, and we denote that with a delta symbol. That's supposed to be a Greek delta, and that's going to be plus, because that oxygen is halfway between neutral and plus, so it's going to be partial plus, and this chlorine is going to be halfway between neutral and minus, so it's going to be partial minus. And that's how we draw a transition state, and this, sometimes by drawing the transition state, it gives us additional insights into whether the reaction ought to be more or less favorable than perhaps another competing pathway. So that's how we think about transition states in organic chemistry.